Hello again, Elements. Today we will be making faux dreads together in my two-part series. I will be getting in touch with my inner dread slash Rasta. Yes, I am Jamaican and a Rasta spiritualist, so I can't wait. But as you can see here, this first dread is like a rope and it is useless because we are making detachable dreads today. Maybe if you wove it on the head like this, but it just won't work for what we're doing today. In this example, I'm showing you what a perfect one will look like with my end result, and this one is just a no. That's the rope that we're taking apart right now. The look was inspired by Angvish or Alux from 2017 to 19. She tried dreads a couple times, and I like the color in the first set but the size in the second set. So I'm going to be designing my dreads in between these two styles. I would like you guys to take note on how much hair is being used in this one single dread, and I don't know what I was thinking, but please forgive me. At least you guys can take note of that, and as you'll see in the second half of the video, how much you're actually supposed to use. But at the same time, let's say you have really short hair and are able to fit your braid into an at least looser base of this size dread, then you know how much hair you need if you want to do a dread this large. The only issue would be how tight I wove it at the top, and I guess anyone should be a little bit looser on the bottom unless you want it to be stiff like in my example. And on top of how stiff it is, I realized that if I have 36 dreads that have this much hair, I'm going to lose my hair because it's going to pull it out. It'll be too heavy. So forget that. Let's go lightweight here. Go easy on our resources. Be a little bit more efficient and look just as good. And then another thing that I would like you guys to just take note of as well is how tedious and difficult it is for me to work with this material. So if you want an easier time and more sleek and real looking dreads, then you're gonna want to invest in a higher quality of extension hair, because this was absolutely the lowest quality that I could get for the price. I got everything on Wish, and I will include a link in the description below what extensions I got, but I just want you guys to make sure that you're aware of the quality I'm using. But it works out for me, so you'll be able to see at the end on my part three of this series if you like the look of the quality of the dreads in the end. So I'm going to take this opportunity to remind you guys to please like and or subscribe. I'm goaling towards creating a lot new different content and different stuff besides wigs and using Rit dye. So I'm experimenting more in the hair world, but I'll also be getting into my artwork more again, and I would like to do some time lapses of my paintings and drawings, so that's going to be coming up soon. But either way, I hope anyone who comes across this video and is about to start this craft that you get some useful tips from me. But just make sure you remember that at the end of this video, it isn't my finished product. This is only my part one, and my dreads will be mixed pink and blonde, so just remember that. All right, I'll catch you guys at about 5 minutes in. Build your penitentiaries. We build your schools. Brainwash education to make us the fools. It reads you reward for our love. Telling us of your God above. We gonna chase those crazy. Chase those crazy bumpers. Chase those crazy bullets out of the yard. Chase those crazy bullets out of town. Okay, great, we are done with the rope. Now we're going to be working on our official product. As you can see, my loop around my secure hook is about an eighth or at least a sixth of what it was before. And you can see I'm just twisting it so that it's not stringy for when the time comes for me to put my braid through, it's not going to deteriorate and just be a huge mess. And so now we have our piece of hair that we'll be wrapping around, and the only thing for you to pay attention to is the fact that there is a space for the hair to go through once I'm done and we'll be installing it. Some areas will be tighter than others, but that's why I'm doing it so many times at the top. And you just want to add as many layers as you need to so that you feel confident that that base will be able to cover your braid when we're finished. You will probably need to take at least 3 or 4 strand bundles in order to wind down the entire lock. And I'm sorry I go out of camera here, you guys, my bad. Maybe now you can see how many times I'm wrapping at least though. And also one more thing to keep in mind is that the reason why this hair looks so crazy is because I'm using the same hair from the last dread that I just took apart. It's not fresh strands from the package, okay? So in my part 2, you'll be able to see what the fresh strands actually look like. But this part, it doesn't matter because this is just the base. And obviously, since I'll be rewrapping it in blonde, you won't see this. It's better for texture anyway, because I'm going for a distressed look, not a sleek look, just so you know. And now that we're moving down the dread, the only part you need to make sure that you do the same as I am is that once you've accumulated a lot of hair in one area, to move it upwards so that you won't have any gaps afterwards. And the other part is while you're spreading the hair, to try and fan it out while you're folding it over your finger, maintaining the fan on your index finger. And you just want to make sure that you're not clumping it on, you're wrapping it in a widespread area. So for the bottom here, guys, I'm going really thin because I do not know how thick I want them yet, to be honest. But obviously I can add more when I do my second coat, let's say. The final pointer is just for you guys to know not to rub, and we will have to use a lighter at this last step in the process, but I will be explaining that all in my part 2 coming next. I'm going to leave it up to you guys to decide how you want to separate the hair and choose what sides you want, but for me to get these 24 inches, it took me 1 3/4 pack to do 18 base locks, meaning it will take me 3.5 packs to do the full 36 set. And you can have a look at how squishy and airy the hair is and if you like that or not. Okay guys, so I'll see you in a couple days when I upload that video, the part 2, when we add the blonde on. Take care.